Hello, welcome back to my channel. We will continue with the forgot password function. We have test sending email. I will go back to the customer route and continue with the forgot password route. We need to check whether the email exists in the database or not in the customer table. So I will go to customer and find the email, find one email error customer. If error occur or customer not found, mean the email not found, we will return 400 status with JSON object. With the message error or customer does not access or email does not access. But if the email is found, we will create a token. We use JWT sign. So we will decode the email customer.email customer ID next is the secret key process dot env. We will need another secret key for our resist password. So I go to dot env file. And I create another resist password key. Or just reset PWT. Sorry, just PW and okay, something like this. I save this file. I copy this and it's here. Process.env JWT reset PWK. And then is the expire time. It will be expired in 20 minutes. And then we will save the token to the database. File one and update. Customer ID. And then token type. Reset password. Token. New, true, and upset is true. Then error and document. If document, you will return 200 status. If document, we will crying here, so I need to check. It should be outside. Should be outside here. If document mean we can update or insert the token to the database, we can then send an email. We send the token to the email of the user. I will replace the token here with the token as we create here. And then I return 200 taters. And else. We will return 400 status 400. Okay, so something like that. Okay. And now I save the code. I already run the app and I'll go to Postman. I hit send. So we got the message error or email does not access. So just because we haven't registered test them out with this email. So I will copy the email here and go to the customer route, and I paste here. Okay. I change the first name and last name. Okay, and now I hit send. Register successfully, and the password 123456. And now I go back to forgot password, and I hit send again. The server error. Don't know what's going on, but let's check. I go back to my code editor and we will check here. It should be file one and update as I select the wrong method. I hit save and I back to the postman and hit send again. So now I got a message, email for reset password has been sent. So now I will check on my email, and I got the link here, password reset link with the real token. Okay, good. And now I will back to my code editor and I will create another route for reset the password. Create a new route. Router dot put reset password with the token. Request resolve. I will get the token from request params. New password. From the body, and then try. I will decode the token JWT verify token process dot env JWT reset password key. And now I will go to the token table and find one I find the token with the customer ID equal to the decoded dot customer ID. And I find the token, the token type is reset password. And I will create an async function here. Should be error and dog. If error, return status. JSON status file, status files, this is invalid token, the data is undefined. Let's just log the error here. And then I will file the customer away. Customer file one email with the decoded email. And then I will encrypt the password. New password. Sort route. Error and hash. If error. I will log the error here and I will return 500 status. With the message error cannot encrypt password. And if hashing password success, we will change the password. It's the mode of password equal hash, and then I will save the password to the database. I use async away. Away customer file one and delete. It should be token. After I save the new password, I will delete the token in the database. Token file one and delete file one and delete here. Customer ID customer dot ID token type with this password. And then I return the 200 status JSON password reset. successfully. And the data is the result. And then I catch the error. Will return 400 status. Server error. And I also catch here. Yep. We should put the error here. And now I will go back to the postman, put I hit send again, and I will receive the email. So I will open my email. I got the link here, and now I will copy this and I create a new request, put methods, and I paste the link here. So I will go to the body and should be new password. My own password is 123456, and now I will change to 123456. I hit send. Cannot put password versus recovery. Should be resist password. I go to the email template and change this, and it should be inside customer, and it should be customer here. Okay, now I go back to the forgot password. I hit send again, and I got the link here. So I copy this and I go to postman. And I hit send again. Oh, I need to give the new password. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now I hit send. Password reset successfully. So now I will log in. I will log in with the own password. It's not working, but now 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and hit send. So log in successfully. So now I have reset the password, and finally we will create another route for change the password. I will create another route, router dot put change password. Change the password. The user need to log in, so I pass the auth middleware async request result conf own password new password customer ID and I create a customer away customer 5 by ID. If customer file, we will pick it the password on password, and this is the own passwords from the body and password and own passwords from the database. We will compare. Does it match or not? And if error, we will return status 404. Status 500. Server error. As if the password match, so we will has the password pick it hash new pass new password sorrow 10 async if error we will return 500 status error cannot encrypt password and here should be error and same thing here And if we can hash the password, so we will save the password to the database customer.password equal hash, and I will save the new password. Save, then update it. Customer. I will return $200. Status true. Message password change has been changed successfully, and the data is updated. Password updated customer. Else here, in case of the own password incorrect, we will return "401 status password own password incorrect." Okay, and now I will test the change password. First we need to get the token here, and I go here, change the password, put okay, it should be HTTP localhost, change password. Authorization bearer, pass the token and the body situation, rely on password 1234567 and new password. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and I hit send. So password has been changed successfully. So now I will log in with the own password. Wrong password, login failed. First I use the new password and hit send. So we log in successfully. So we have done with the tutorial, we can register for the new user, we can log in, log out, we can change the password, and if we forgot the password, we will provide the email, and you will receive the email with the token, and we use that you can use the link from the email, and you change the password and authorize user to, is for to get your user detail. So I will upload my source code to the GitHub so that you can download it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to get a new tutorial. Thank you.